So our need area is bowel obstruction, specifically the need statement that we've come up with after many hours of discussion is a way to decrease hospital days due to small bowel obstruction in patients with prior abdominal surgery. We chose the hospital days, decreasing that time, because we felt like that would be something concrete that we can measure. And we chose small bowel obstruction, even though we'd initially been given adhesions, because it was a diagnosis to really work with than adhesions, which you can't exactly measure.
We got started on doing the market analysis by just some internet searching. Some of it was for looking at potential like market research reports, because medicine is a business, so there are other people who have looked at some of these things. But we also found a lot of really useful information in the academic journals, and so even if the purpose of the academic studies is not directly focused on the market, if it's focused more about the solutions or the outcomes, there's a lot of very useful data there about how many patients were treated and how much it costs sometimes.
Some of the websites are not very convenient. It takes a lot of work to sort through it and find the information, but I think just the more and more you do it, the easier it gets.
We found some government databases that were really good to find information on hospitalizations, cost, how much the hospital gets reimbursed, and that is really what we ended up using in our current analysis.
The CMS website. Now, of course, that's for Medicare patients, but it was a difficult to sort through, but it had a lot of great information in there.
Yeah, and a lot of the academic journals we found through PubMed.
I thought it was important to go back to the root data, that every time we dug into a publication, that you would add a certain degree of error, and then if you multiplied those by each other, then you just compounded the inaccuracy of the data. So it was helpful to find the root data in the National Inpatient Survey from the HRQ.
We're looking at academic publications. Very useful, the list of citations at the end of it is a great way to see, yeah, where did this data come from, and gives you an introduction to other researchers, other resources that are out there. And so, yeah, that was very useful for us.
I think inherently there's lots of different sources and you're going to get different numbers. We then just took a look at all of them. Some of them were from different dates, and so a lot older ones, especially cost and even numbers, aren't going to be correct. So we tried to find the most recent, and then of those, the kind of what was straight from the source, that if it's from the government website that actually did the surveys, but then also making sure you're paying attention to the population. Was it private insurance versus Medicare? And some of those, it's not that one's right or wrong, they're just different, and then you have to figure out what subset of that population. And I think we also then, when we're doing estimates, try to pick a middle line, so you have the smallest number and the largest numbers and pick somewhere in the middle to be more realistic.
One big challenge is when you're trying to distribute work, oftentimes we would do research on our own and we'd come up with our own sets of data, and then we'd come back together and compare our data, and oftentimes they were discordant. And so it actually ended up being important for us to go through the process of validating our data and then deciding upon which set we were going to use as a group for consistency.